person on the boat, Trump.
You are entitled to have that view, and I'm going to treat you with respect and civility, even if not everyone in this process does. I'll tell you, this election matters. It matters a lot. You need someone to do
it. It does matter.
So I appreciate your coming out. I appreciate you coming out and standing up. And I think this entire process, I think anyone that wants to be president owes it to the people of this state to come in front of you and ask for your support. And I'm running to be everyone's president, those who vote for me, even those
we don't want you.
Well, you're entitled to your view, sir, and I will respect it. In fact, I will.
Do the math.
I will.
Now you have cases to drop out. It's your turn.
Well,
take your own word.
Now I'm curious, sir.
I would drop out.
When Donald doesn't get to 1237, you're
going
to call him to drop out.
Donald's definitely going to get to 1237. No, he's going to get more than 1237.
Let me ask you something, sir. What do you like about Donald?
Everything.
Give me one.
Everything.
Give me one. Can you think any?
Donald, Donald,
the wall.
Okay, the wall.
That's the main thing. Immigration.
All right, hold on a second. Now, do you know on the wall that Donald told the New York Times editorial board he's not going to build a wall, and he's not going to deport anyone?
Once again, LyingTed!
Well, sir, no, actually, civilized people don't just scream and yell at each other. I'm not yelling at you. Do you know that Donald Burke were caught on tape? The New York Times reported the whole thing, publicly reported. That's a total lie.
You are the problem.
Can I ask you something? Out of all of the candidates, name one who had $1 million judgment against him for hiring anybody.
Name one.
Donald Trump is the
only one. That's right.
Okay,
not
so,
you.
So you like
you.
Rich people
where's
who
your
buy politics.
Where's your Goldman Sachs jacket at? We know your wife works there.
Actually, I was supported by, and am supported by, 1.3 million contributions all over the country. Our average contribution is $60. On immigration, you know Donald Trump had $1 million judgment against him for hiring illegal aliens. You know what he's doing right now in Florida? He brings in hundreds of foreign workers instead of hiring Americans. Sir, with all respect, Donald Trump is deceiving you. He is playing you for a chump. And ask yourself two questions. Why is it that the mainstream media so desperately wants Donald Trump to be the Republican nominee? And why is it that John Boehner supports Donald Trump? Do you agree with John Boehner?
No.
Do you agree with Nancy Pelosi?
The thing is, they
don't agree
with everybody, but I believe in Trump. He's the only one that's going to put us where we need to be. So what are you going to do about the Second Amendment?
Okay, great question.
What are you going to do about
the Second Amendment?
Yeah.
All right, I have defended the Second Amendment in front of the Supreme Court of the United States. Do you know that Donald Trump supported Bill Clinton's national ban on some of the most popular firearms in America? And that is a fact. You go read his book where he said, I agree with Bill Clinton. In fact, he said, I hate guns. That's a quote from Donald Trump. I have spent 20 years fighting to defend the Second Amendment. And I'll tell you this, sir. If Donald Trump ever becomes president, he has said on the Supreme Court he's going to cut a deal with Chuck Schumer. He said that in two debates ago, which means he's going to put a liberal on the Supreme Court. He's going to take away your Second Amendment right. There is a reason why Gun Owners of America has endorsed me in this campaign, because I've defended the Second Amendment my whole life. Well, Donald Trump is a New York liberal who will take away your Second Amendment rights. This man is lying to you, and he's taking advantage of you. And I would encourage you, sir, I appreciate your being out here speaking. If I were Donald Trump, I wouldn't have come over and talked to you. I wouldn't have shown you that respect. In fact, you know what I would have done? I would have told the folks over there, go over and punch those guys in the face. That's what Donald does to protesters. I think a candidate is campaigning to work for you. Okay, stop. What word did I say was a lie?
About Donald telling people to punch people.
Okay, but let me ask you, sir. Just go home and Google Donald punch in the face protesters. And at his rallies, look, this is on national television. You can watch the facts of him standing at the podium saying, punch that guy in the face. I mean, that's, and in fact, he says, I'll pay your legal fees when you punch him in the face. And there's a problem. Listen, Donald Trump has accused everyone in this race of being a liar. Donald cannot tell the truth in 1 minute.
You'll find out tomorrow. So, yeah, don't want you.
Well, sir, you are entitled to have your rights, but I'll tell you what. Sir, America is a better country
without you.
Thank you for those kind sentiments. Let me point out, I have treated you respectfully the entire time. And a question that everyone here should ask.
Are you Canadian?
Do you want your kids repeating the words of Donald Trump? Would you be proud if your kids came and yelling and insulting? And let me give you an example of Donald's problems with the truth.